Hold up.
I just bodied the big red machine. Y'all saw that.
Gold. Everybody's gonna touch it. Everybody's breathing. Freeze. Good practice today, fellas.
So much, yes, man. Always.
When we got here, mad early.
Yeah, when did you get here?
We got here like 2, I'd say.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we got here wicked early. We went over to see if there's any games, and there was none.
Well, welcome, my newest member.
No. You mean car keys?
Bernie does.
Or we don't get unlocked. Is that what you're asking for, car keys?
Yeah.
The annual Cardinal Classic Tournament is held on Pope Francis Ice in Springfield, Massachusetts. With playoff seeding on the line, these are perhaps the two most crucial games of the entire season.
I mean, going that late in the year, we always take that tournament as like the pre to the playoffs. So we go into that tournament and we're like, that's kind of our momentum. That's what's like our first page of like, this is when we need to bear down.
Before this season, we never won that tournament. We always know that tournament's gonna be a battle also. Pope and CM are always very good. Us and Central Catholic are always pretty even.
The road to this point has seen the Spartans go through several of the top teams in the state of Massachusetts, and the next 2 days will be no exception. Tournament participants include perennially top-ranked teams Catholic Memorial, Central Catholic, and Pope Francis.
When you're traveling like this, sometimes young teams get distracted with the different things, whether you're staying in a hotel or all the other stuff that goes along with it. And the last thing that you actually are thinking about is what you're here for. And what you're here for today is to make a statement across the state, because this is one of those tournaments that everybody looks at. It really is. Not only will it affect our seeding in the tournament, but it will hopefully boast your reputation, which is a big thing. So today, we'll put a whole season of practices, blackboards, talks, all of that comes down to this time of year now. This is the time of year that it matters. And you want to enter the tournament playing your best. And playing your best is X's and O's, students of the game, and everybody staying not too high, not too low, but staying together. Because we're gonna make mistakes. Everybody makes them. But we need to support each other. and work through any of that and then celebrate when we are obviously successful. We're playing some of the better teams in the state, and it's a great, this is a gift. It's a great opportunity to be out here and to represent not only your families, your school, and your program and what we've tried to accomplish all year. So today is where it begins to show our end result for this year. So working hard, discipline, staying out of the box, all the things that have hurt us in the past have got to be good today. Because you know what we want to do? We want to play in that championship game tomorrow. Because anything can happen, and we know that. So let's take care of business. Again, it's one period at a time, one shift at a time. Do your job one time, one shift at a time, that is. One shift at a time. Come off satisfied with you, what you've done out there. Let's have a good day.
So boys, come on.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Let's go, boys.
Being the underdog, there's nothing better than it, I think, in my mind. And I would say that to the boys nonstop. Like, you gotta love being the underdog. You gotta love being the underdog.
Now, we know if we're the underdog in the team, we're gonna spend a lot of time in the DM, so we're gonna have to work hard, take away passing lanes, and just block shots. So I think being the underdog really just helps us play our best hockey.
Just a face off in the defensive zone where you win it back and then the forward just skates straight out, like in between the defensemen, and you throw it off either the blue line or the red line. I just skate out, so you have to ask Jakey, the blue line, and then you just go in on a breakaway usually, and yeah, it never really worked throughout the season, but it just happened to work perfectly because that guy fell down and Jakey threw a dot out, and
All right, so that can't happen. That's one of those things we talked about. We had that D-zone talk the other day in practice. We went over the D-zone, taking a deep breath, remembering where you're supposed to be. Everyone has a job. We're not running around doing everyone else's job. That's what we did the other day. That's what will make us lose a game. We can't do that. Take a deep breath and go to your spot and play defense. That's it.
So that was a good good period with 10 turnovers for us. 10 turnovers. So we can't continue to go the next two periods with 10 turnovers in a period or it will come back to haunt us. Okay, understand that. You can have a turnover in the offensive zone, which we did, the neutral zone and the D zone, there were several turnovers. Just pumping pucks to areas that go on your opponent's stick is a turnover. Understand that. You need to be better with the puck. It's defense first. Guess what? Guess what? Already, we don't need another goal to win if they don't score. We don't need another one. We have to be really good in our zone, and with that, you're gonna find some opportunities. But we're not selling out for the second goal that absolutely means nothing if we don't let them score. So understand, we're here to win. And you could already have won this game if you're real good in our zone. That's important.
No. Oh, it's off. All right, thank God.
Oh my God, the goalie's going to the bench.
What?
As has been the case in multiple games this season, the game remains tied late into the third period. For a team that emphasizes defense first, their blue liners seem to have a hand in a lot of the offense.
Chances, we buried a couple and then they didn't finish, and then after that we were able to move on to Pope Francis.
We made some mistakes, obviously we did. You know, a 2-1 victory, all we came here for, get that W and move on to the championship game, but learn from this. I mean, they had an opportunity right to the very second, okay? 14 seconds left, I think the faceoff was down in their zone and they ended up having a scoring opportunity. That shouldn't happen, should never happen, okay? So we gotta be better. The next two teams are better. So we got two, but we came for four. So I'm very proud of the way that you conduct yourselves. You played hard. The officials actually complimented me on how you guys play the game. But tomorrow we gotta be even better. A lot of guys gave a lot today, and I know that. And we know that as a staff. That's why you came away with 2 points. But tomorrow, let's get a couple more.
It's going to take 3 periods against either one of those teams. They're both good squads. So we got to come and play like we did in the first and the third. And just use our brains on those situations. All right? At the end of the game, they got a little dicey.
One other thing that we overlook. I mean, you got a guy in net that's giving you opportunities to win. Give it up for your boys.
Fellas, we keep climbing the mountain together as a family. This is the best time of year right now. You came out here, you executed on another game plan. One goal in our net, all right, we'll have a chance to win those games. So Coach Lee says all year long what we say as a staff, defense first, hockey wins. When we don't let up a lot of goals, we win hockey games. So we just got to keep buying into that mentality, right? So good job, guys, doing all little things right. We got to keep this train flying.
Get some rest. Go to bed at a decent hour because we're playing at 1 o'clock. That's an early game. 1 o'clock. And you know what? It's a lot better than f***ing 11, isn't it?
Have we won the tournament yet?
We've been in the finals. 2 years ago, we lost in overtime in the finals. So, let's go.
Come on, boys. Let's bring home a trophy.
Holger has something to say.
Give this to someone who I think kept us.
Training's the one tournament we don't bring the knee hockey.
The night between games is a welcome distraction from what is at stake. the boys have plenty of time to relax with their teammates. One can argue that with playoff positioning on the line, the night off actually puts the guys at ease for the next day.
I think the most important thing as a team is to also be friends outside of the sport. So it's always good to hang out with each other. That was a fun tournament. We had fun in the hotel in between games.
Day in the life of Jake Gang.
I didn't realize, like, I actually, like, it was kind of yucky, too.
The Shelly was gross.
No, I forced it, dude. I forced it.
Like,
I
didn't. Coaches were pissed.
I know, bro. Watch, it was perfect, though. To Bolzy, and then I'm right there. Oh. Watch, I'm like, you know what? I need this. I forced it, dude. What's Coach Smitty was probably like,
Smitty was like, come on, dude.
He was like,
who's
like,
Cam's.
Oh, I got the cameraman in here now? Oh, yeah. You cannot get this on camera. I'm getting creamed.
It's 3-0, dude.
Jaden mercyed me. Good thing you weren't here for that.
Who's playing
Chow
on the other?
Yeah! Dude, it's CM. Let's go, baby. 4-0 Cardinals. You know what to do. They're out of people, bro. This is good content.
Are you filming this game?
No.
You just want the content?
Yeah, I just need the content.
Just now we're going to kill Pope tomorrow.
Yo, you see that fan section behind us, baby? Are you going to show us? They're getting shellied into it. I'm going to break their hearts when we win the championship. This is so good.
I just sat in that line for it. It's unbelievable. This is the best
drink you've scored.
Oh, God. Those things are awful. What the f*** are you talking about?
Yo. Don't ever post this clip of me saying that.
Put your head on the thing, though. Like, I love it.
Nah, start hitting me. Like.
All right, boys. It's set.
We got to f***ing come out buzzing, bro. Like, if we don't, we're going to be flat and we're not going to win. So we got to come out hard.
No.
Like, that ass. For the boys.
Yeah,
for the boys at home.
Go. Go.
I went from Bauer to Warrior.
Dude,
to
the CCM. I went from everywhere. I was just Bauer for a while, and yeah, then I went to. I switched
like
between Nexus
stick
and like.
Off of
they
poke
have
check.
This stick. This is the best stick of all time. This stick is so nasty, dude. Like, tell me this stick isn't nasty.
This stick is nasty.
This is the best stick Bauer ever made.
No, I don't. I haven't been to Bauer in a while.
The
I broke my stick off a. Poke check.
The MX3 is the best stick ever.
I'm not flexing it. I'm gonna break it.
Stick is so nasty.
Larkin, that's kind of gross curve. I like that curve.
Dude, how much?
Before the game began, it became clear that the road to a tournament win would be even tougher. The team will be short a man this afternoon, as freshman Joey Calder will be forced to miss the game due to a hand injury suffered the night before.
Calder, show Brandy your finger.
Yeah, you're not. You're out.
Oof. Alright, boys, full focus today, deadass. This is a championship game. Big win yesterday, now we get a home game for States. Imagine the momentum if we win this championship right here. Imagine the momentum for us going in. Like, if we beat Pope right now,
imagine the feeling after the game.
Bro, imagine our names. Imagine our names. Just keep on working. Just go hard today and don't let up. I'm sorry, but yesterday letting up that goal, that's on me. But today, keep on working your ass off. You guys did great yesterday. Like, keep on working.
Yo, have each other's backs out there, bro. Trust each other. You guys gotta have. You guys gotta have trust.
And yo, don't be intimidated by these kids. Like, dead ass. You can't get intimidated by these kids. Not without Ryan.
They go to Pope Francis. Don't give them any respect. We can beat this team, dude. We gotta eat shots, though.
We gotta hit them too. They gotta. The only way. They gotta be. I don't want to sound like a loser right now, but the only way we're gonna win this game is if we play St. Mary's. Blue collar hockey and just work our tail off and get to the front of the net, dude. It's a fact. It's the only way we're gonna win. I hope you boys understand.
Let's go.
Yeah! Let's go. Spines on three. 1, 2, 3.
Spines!
All right, let's get in there. Here we go.
Once we watched the Pope versus Catherine Memorial game, we really knew that we could battle with both teams.
They could be better than us skill wise. Basically, like Newburyport, we were better than Newburyport skill wise. They played physical. They played hard. They tied the game, and I think we came with the same mindset against Pope Francis. You know, we may not have as much skill as them, but we sure as hell can work harder and play more physical.
Earned your ability to play in the championship game, but again, the game is no different than any other game. It's all played the same. You just want more energy, and we want guys to be focused and more disciplined today. Understand when you take the ice, this game is not going to be won in the first minute, the first shift, the first period. It's a marathon. You have to be consistently good. You have to focus the entire time you're on the ice, and we're going to play some time in our zone. And that is where, if you didn't learn that yesterday, that's where you win. You win when you beat your opponent in your own zone. Defense first hockey is what will win this. So we're not selling out. We're going to be really good. We're going to frustrate them. We're going to take lanes away. We're going to block shots. We're going to use our sticks. And again, your opponent's always to the wall. We want layers to our net. Chipping pucks to safe areas. And that's how you're going to create some offense. Just play the game hard. Finish your checks. You know what's successful and what isn't now. This is it. Last game of the season. We've had the ups and downs. Remember what got you that high. And remember what put us low. And eliminate it. And work together as a team. Nobody can do it in here alone. This is a total team effort today from everybody. From your goaltender to your defensive core to your forwards. If everybody does their job, you're going to come back in this room a happy team. One shift at a time, outwork your opponent. One-on-one battles. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Let's go, boys.
Go!
Gate, they stuck it to us. I think the shots were 6-0 after 4 minutes, and we were all kind of, I think everyone in the rink kind of thought that this could get ugly.
I think we knew they were going to be pretty good going in, but we worked hard. We knew, after about the first period, I say, we realized like we have a good chance of beating this team. They're not that much better. They're just high school kids like us, so if we just dial in, play a good game, and we'll see what happens.
Goody! Yeah! Let's go!
Dude, I'm so fired up.
I wish my boy Calder was out there and be working his tail off on the boards.
Yo,
you boys off. Let's f***ing go.
15 minutes left. One period. 15 minutes of St. Mary's hockey. And how we win is exactly what you've seen. And that's defense first hockey. And we were good in our zone. We frustrated them because we had guys stopping on pucks, stopping the side, taking lanes away. Taking responsibility for their job in our zone. The shots were pretty even. The play was even. We f***ing went from killing it, two men down to one man down to coming even and f***ing scoring. It was a very good period. So now, this being your last game of the season, That's what we've learned. Let's close the deal. Let's finish the job. Understand, it's going to take every bit of energy you have. Every single guy in here. And you can't take 10 seconds off when you're on the ice. You can't take that off.
Take a second.
Commit to it. Commit to it. And understand, okay, I'm a little less with the energy. I'm going to go, instead of 50 seconds, I'm going to go 25, 30 seconds. And go quick. And stay out of the box. And do your job, whether you're the center, whether you're the wing, whether you're the defenseman, okay? Do your job. And I like our chances. You know what it takes. It's gonna take everything you got. But if you got it, we're gonna be happy after this game.
This has been an awesome experience for all of us. We're all together. So look to the left and to the right of you. You guys are right with one of the best teams in the state, and you're all laying it on the ice for each other. We have to continue to do that. Ailes, that back check, I've never seen a kid skate that fast. That was fucking unbelievable. You prevented a two-on-one. You know why? Because you decided that you wanted it deep down in your belly. Everyone needs to decide that we want it deep down in our bellies right now. For all of us. And you can go out there and achieve something really awesome today. All right? You guys understand that?
Coach.
Let's fucking do this as a family, together. Let's go out there and fucking lay it on the line right now. Let's go, boy.
Leave it all out there. Come on. We need this. And they're gone.
Let's rip an Our Father real quick, huh?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's go. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Oh, my God. Same team, boys.
Three guys run the same part.
Third period, I let up a brutal shot from the point. Oh, it should have never went into overtime. But I let that up, and then I couldn't really let that get to me because I knew that if we were going to win this game, I couldn't let up another goal.
Since a winner is needed to decide the tournament, there will be at least two overtimes, then a shootout if necessary. Because the game will end in a shootout, it will show on both teams' records as a tie, as shootouts are not customary in typical regular season games. This will simply decide the tournament winner. Still, the momentum a win could bring would carry the Spartans into postseason play on a high note.
Because you know every shot matters, because you only get, you don't even know how many you get.
So before that, Coach Direct called my name for the fifth guy. I was like, huh, here we go. And I was like, all right, they didn't shoot once. I'm gonna go block aside. And so I went up, I was shaking the whole time, and I just ripped it block aside, and prayer happened.
I love shootouts. It's just mano a mano. It's you versus them. It's just the better man's gonna win. I got lucky a couple times. They hit two posts, missed the net once, but it's what happens at the end. You know, I was in the right position. That's why they hit the post.
They came through for the boys, and we just had to watch and trust them, and they came through.
I told you.
Great job. Great job. Good luck in the tournament, fellas.
Hope we see you.
Yeah, thank you. Right. You for 10 people. Good job.
Let's go! This ice sucks.
What's the matter? Here we go.
You are so handsome.
We're good. Thank you.
Yeah, bro!
First goal.
Yeah!
We got Ike shootout winner.
Yeah!
Oh, this is a tough one. What do we say, boys? I'm gonna give it Ike!
Ten, 7-5, and 15th in the power rankings. That is the final regular season record of a team not many expected to contend at all. A blue-collar bunch that prides itself on a style of hockey that traditionalists of the game would call throwback. Never tell a hockey player that it's just a game. As for those who lace up the skates, those who cheer from the stands, and those who dedicate their lives to the game, this sport is a way of life. No bond is quite as strong as the one that would compel a group of young men to give blood and sweat for the man sitting in the locker room stall next to them. For the intensity they give the sport is matched in the glory it can give in return. So as we approach the finale of season one, remember these words. Hockey may, in fact, just be a game, yet it is also who these men are. But the fun is not quite over yet.